This conference will now be recorded.
Can you able to see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, cool. So quickly we'll start our today's topics. So yesterday we were discussing about resource group creation and the resource group creation with Azure portal and also resource group creation with PowerShell script. At the same time, we just a basic introduction covered about storage, like what are the two types of storage accounts that we have and what are the components in it. But we'll see in detail today. Related to yesterday's topics, have you guys got a chance to practice, or do you have any doubts? Just let me know so that I'll quickly cover those and then we'll quickly move on to the storage part. Okay, then I'll take it as no. Then okay, thanks guys. So we'll quickly moving on to the today's topic called storage accounts. So opening my Azure portal. So as I covered yesterday, we have two different types of storage accounts available in the market. So this is the Azure portal, guys. If you want to create any storage accounts, either you can go and select from the favorites button here, go to the favorites button, you have a storage accounts here, or you can actually search it from the market store. Market store will have all the ready-made solutions available for you, which is offered by either by Microsoft or by third party vendor. So the storage is completely a Microsoft product. So Microsoft is going to support this infrastructure. So we are going to search for storage accounts. So when you select this, so it is asking you to create the storage account. When I say click on create, so you're getting a couple of options here. So like what types of options we will see in detail, but let me cover the topic and let me give you some theory, then we'll move on to the slab session. So people who are there in the call may already know storage is used to store the data. It might be any kind of data, like it might be a raw data, it might be a metadata, it might be structured, it might be unstructured, or it might be a huge file, it might be a very small file. It doesn't matter what kind of file you are actually storing. It is simply a device you can say it is a device where you have a capability of storing 500 terabytes of data. It's a piece of hardware which is being offered by Microsoft. We are not managing that particular piece of hardware. Microsoft is managing the hardware and they are giving you the space, 500 terabytes of space, and whatever you actually upload or whatever you actually download. So it depends upon your usage basis, Microsoft is going to charge you. That's what we call it as pay as you go. How much you use, that much you pay. That is the concept behind the storage part. Now, as I said yesterday, we have two different types of storage accounts. Anyone, can you please tell me what is the first one? What are the two different types yesterday we have discussed?
Premium,
right?
Standard.
Right, cool. Right. So Well, yesterday we have seen what is a, I mean, we have not, I mean, just discussed what are two different types. We call them as types. Okay. Now, in this type also, we have ready-made services. Let's say if I create a storage account with standard, okay, standard type, automatically it, whenever it creates, okay, you will get four default services in the storage account. So what are those services? We'll see in detail now. And first of all, we'll also see what is the standard storage account, and then we'll move on to the services. First one is blobs, second one is files, next one is tables, queues, and similarly, premium also have some services. Okay, first one is blob, tables, and queues. Okay, now why premium is only offering these three and why standard is actually offering many? We'll discuss that in detail, but let's quickly start with so okay, one second, these are all called as services. What are the services offering by standard storage account? Then you have to say blobs, files, tables, and queues. First of all, you have to ask a question like, are you asking about a storage or a premium storage? Then if it is a premium, then you have to tell these three services. If it is standard storage, then you have to answer this four services: blobs, files, tables, and queues. Let's talk about a blob. So you guys want to store some data into this standard storage. Let's example, let's say first one. Like I want to create a storage account with a standard type, and now I want to put some data into this blobs. If I want to put some data into these blobs, I can't actually, you know, directly go ahead and put directly, like a, it's not like a pen drive or it's not like your mobile phone, directly connect the cable here and just drag and drop your files. So we have certain, as this is a cloud technology, you have to follow, you know, Microsoft standards, however they have given you the type of access. Now you see here, we have a standard storage account. Inside that, you have to use a service called blobs. If you want to store some files or any kind of data, you want to, you can actually store it in the blobs only. Okay, why only blobs? Because blobs can store any kind of data, because here this is the main part, which here itself you will store all your data. It might be any kind of data, structured, unstructured. It has a capability of storing all these files. But is it possible to directly dump all the data inside this blob? Yes, it is possible, but you can't directly store into the blobs. How you can't directly store into the standard storage? You have to use the blobs here. So here also, in order to store some data into the blobs, you have to create a container. Okay, container is nothing but a folder. Okay, whenever, let's say you are creating some images, okay, in this blob you can actually store some data. Okay, in this, as I'm telling, you can actually store 500 terabytes. The capacity of the storage, yesterday I have discussed, is 500 terabytes. But in order to store any kind of data into the standard storage, you have to come to the blobs. Inside the blobs only you can store, but after creating the container. So let's talk about a container. I'll give you a small example. Let's take a mobile phone. You'll have your mobile phone, right? I mean, earlier, before Android comes into the market, we have these Nokia, Symbian operating system mobile phones. So what happens, you know, whenever you get a new mobile phone, you have these memory card options on those mobile phones. So earlier, whenever you know, you want to store some data, let's say you have taken some image, I mean you want to copy some data into your phone, you used to connect your phone to the computer, and then you used to create some folders. Like for images, you create image folder. For movies, you create movies. For videos, you create videos. And then for MP3 files, you'll create songs or music. So why do you create all those? For two, let's say you have a 2 GB space with the memory card. So in that scenario, if you don't create those folders, what happens? If you dump all the data into that 2GB storage, it becomes very clumsy. So that's the reason you categorize the data in order to access them very quickly. Okay, access speed. So whenever you want to access a file, so okay, you want as a particular image, okay, you go to that particular image folder and you will get that file. You want a song, okay, you go to that particular MP3 or a music folder, okay, and you select the song and you'll just pick it up. So it's very easy to be easy when you categorize the data and you just put it in some different folders. Okay, here also, as for 2GB itself, you are creating those many folders. Here Microsoft storage has 500 terabytes of capacity and it's required to create a container because it's very useful to categorize your data. Now let's say you want to store you have some project information, let's say you have some documents like 100 PDF files. So these files, if you just simply store it in the blobs, let's assume we don't have a container kind of facility, so you can create a folder, but let's say, I mean, that time maybe they may give you, but now if you don't have a container, you know, you dump those PDF files into this blob, and again you bring some some big data kind of thing, and you just start dumping that, and it becomes, you know, very clumsy in order to find that particular piece of a file. Okay, so that's the reason Microsoft gave you this container kind of a blob. Inside the blob you have a container. Okay, let me write it here. So this container is like simply to categorize your data. So it is like nothing but creating a folder in your Windows machine, okay, to store some data. Now let's say if you want to store some images, okay, you just name it as images, and then you start putting your data inside this container, and without container you can't actually upload the data. Remember the point, in standard storage all the four services are available. If you want to store some data, you have to create a container, and inside the container only you can actually dump data. And now here you can actually store data. Okay, got the scenario, guys. And this is a blob, and the functionality here also in premium also, it's as simple as similar as that. So here also you have a container kind of service, and you can't directly store the data inside this. Similarly, you have to create a container, and then only you can store your data, even it is a premium. So the major difference is only the performance, guys. The performance, as I said, you'll get some good latency and good speed when you compare with a premium storage and standard storage. That's the reason people opt for the premium, not in all the scenarios, as it is a costly. So even in standard also we have a couple of options here. I will explain you all those now. Okay, so in this standard, when initially Microsoft has Microsoft created the storage account concept, so they are calling that as a version 1. Okay, so now let's talk about the data what we put inside this storage. So the version 1 is the one earlier when Microsoft initially, so long back, like 3 months back, 3 or 4 months back, Microsoft is only having version 1. Now Microsoft has a new version called V2. So this V2 is like a new version in this. They have done some changes to the storage. I mean, not to this entire part, whatever you see on the screen. What is a change? And that's what I'm talking about, a change now. Now, container. Let's take example. I have only one file, one image file. Okay. I stored in this container. Now, I can actually, whatever the data you store inside this container, will get some URL, unique reference link. So by using this URL, you can actually browse that. Let's say I have uploaded an image, and if I go to the properties of it, I will get some link. If I go to my browser and if I just paste the link and if I click on enter, you can able to access that image file. So I can able to see what is that image. So image will be displayed on my web browser. We will see it in the lab now. So I'm able to view that image file. So not only me, whoever having that particular link can able to access that particular file from anywhere in the world. So the major change that they have done in version 2 storage account is they have implemented a virtual network concept. Virtual network. VNet. We call it as VNet in Azure. So networks. So by using this virtual network, you can actually limit the what we say. Let's say limit the range of this particular storage account. Let's say if you configure a VNet to this particular storage account, then you can actually, let's say now the URL, whatever URL is globally accessible. URL is now globally accessible. Let's say in V2, if you configure a virtual network to a storage account within this network, let's talk about an office network. In office network, whatever you want to see the application or whatever the data you want to see within the office only, it works, right? Because they are in a separate network. Here also, virtual network is kind of, you know, separate network where within this network only this storage account is accessible. Let's say out of this network. So out of this network, if let's say I take example, this VNet is configured with the storage account, and also I have created two virtual machines on this, two VMs. So I have two VMs. So from these two machines, if I try to access the URL, it is accessible. It can be accessible because these two machines also in the same network. Let's say if there is a third VM which is a different VNet, which is using different virtual network, then that machine can't able to access it, right? So in order to make this connection, you have to do some configuration called peering. We call it as VNet to VNet configuration of cross premise connectivity. You will talk about during the VPN concepts. So you are very clear right now. In V2 storage account type, in version 2 storage account, we have this virtual network concept available. If you configure a virtual network to the storage account, you can actually limit this access. So instead of this link accessible via globally, we can actually, if you configure a virtual network within this network only, the link will be accessible. Whatever the resource within this network, they can able to access the storage account. Okay, so that's how we limit the risk. We limit this access of the storage account by using this V2 virtual networks. So this is a major difference. And we have Microsoft is actually giving couple of replications. This is one of the important topic. So as who is taking care of the infrastructure, guys? Microsoft is actually taking care of the infrastructure. Okay, now when I say Microsoft is taking care of the infrastructure, so let's take an example. In Chennai, we have in 2016 we ran into floods. So during that time, it's a natural disaster. So that disaster, during that time, Microsoft data center was closed for 2 days. Think you have created the storage account in South India, which is in Chennai region. So why you have created is like it is near to you. So you are in Hyderabad and you want to connect to the Chennai region. It's very nearby, so that whatever the data you want to access, it would be very you'll get with a good speed because you are near to the data center, right? So, but 2 days it was closed. In that kind of scenario, what about your data? So is your storage account is gonna work or is it gonna stop for temporarily? Means data center is closed in the sense temporarily they have completely shut down the data center. I'm not talking about just simply closing the door and going away. Okay, just completely they have shut down the entire infrastructure which is in the Chennai data center, because this is going to affect their infrastructure, because floods, due to heavy floods, you know, water just went inside the data center and it's a big mess here then during that time. So they have closed for 2 days. Then in that kind of scenario, what about your data? You store it in the South India. Let's say it is a critical data. Then Microsoft has a feature called replications. Okay, I'm going to talk it. Let me take me. Yeah. You here, in order to, as they are supporting that infrastructure, Microsoft has given this feature called replication. So what is this replications? So here, first one, standard storage account. So I'm taking standard LRS. Second one, standard GRS. Third one, standard. As I'm talking about standard storage, so I'm just taking standard RA GRS. Now premium also we have premium LRS, similarly premium GRS, premium RAGRS. So these are the two types of replications. This is premium and this is standard. Okay, now you have these two types of replications. What is this LRS? Local redundant storage. Local. So somewhere noted down, guys, because you may in interview may ask these questions. Local redundant storage. So this is geo redundant storage. This is read access geo redundant storage. Okay, LRS stands for local redundant storage, GRS stands for geo redundant storage, RAGRS stands for read access geo redundant storage. So now I'll explain you this concept. What is this replication and why they are actually offering this replication? Who is gonna replication in the sense like copying the data from one location to another location? Replication, I think, guys, can you tell me what is a replication? Have you I mean whoever working in maybe Abhi, I think whoever working in some companies, you know, they can give you some examples.
Yeah, Shiva, Karthik here.
Yeah.
Replication is nothing but the exact copy, you can say. I mean, mirroring. The exact data which is writing onto one disk, you can exactly replicate into the another area. So whereas you will have a duplicate copy, you can see.
Right, you are absolutely correct. So replication is nothing but, you know, it's a duplication of data. It's nothing but a mirror image. Let's say you have your storage account in South India. So Microsoft is going to replicate with some other same hardware cluster, so that, you know, your data is going to have one more duplicate copy. So we'll talk about one by one now. When I'm talking about replications, the first point is a standard LRS. I think it's better to take one more. Yeah. So first one, standard or a premium. So it's simple, standard or a premium LRS. Now it's maybe standard or it may be premium, it's fine. Let's talk about LRS replication. LRS stands for local redundant storage. When I say local, let's assume we have a data center which is nearby called South India. Okay, South India. This is a South India data center. In this South India data center, where you're gonna put your data? So you have a lot of clusters, lot of hardware equipment inside this. Inside the data center. Now I have lot of hardware here, so you don't know which cluster you are. If you want to upload some, you created a storage account in South India, okay, and you have uploaded a file. You don't know where it got stored in the data center, right? Let's assume this first one. This is the first cluster where we are storing our data right now. So you have your data here in this place. Okay, so you have your data here. Now when you are using this LRS replication, Microsoft is actually going to replicate this local redundant stands. So locally they are actually replicating your data with one more cluster. Okay, so they will not have only one, they will have two more. So which means you will have three copies locally.
So whenever
you are using this standard LRS replication, local redundant storage, Microsoft is gonna, this is, let's say this is your source storage account, so Microsoft is gonna replicate this three copies within the data center, not outside the data center. Whenever you take local redundant storage replication, whenever you select it, Microsoft is going to replicate your data with another clusters. Okay, what happens by using this scenario? Whenever you let's say if this cluster is failed due to some hardware failure or due to some physical damage or due to some hardware issue. Okay, in that kind of scenario, if your storage account is not available, Microsoft has one more copy they will do the failover, and then you know your data, whatever the data you have, will be available to you. So that's how they maintain the backups. So I mean, not the backup, I mean this is a kind of replication. So they replicate your data. So once you know, once it comes back, then they will do the switchover. Automatically you will be access to your primary storage account. So every day, let's say you put some image in that particular main storage account, that will be replicated with the another storage account. That's how it happens in fraction of seconds. This is a LRS replication. Locally, you are replicating your data within the data center, then it is called as a local redundant storage. So we'll quickly move on to the GRS, geo redundant storage. Now there are some customers who says like, okay, recently you have a South India data center down, so in that kind of scenario, I'm only having copies in my single data center. Then what about, let's say, if this is completely breakdown, if this data center is completely gone down, then in that kind of scenario, what happens to my data? So that's the reason there is a one more or two more replications called GRS. So talking about standard or a GRS replication, geo redundant storage. This geo redundant storage, okay, let's take okay now South India, this is West India, like Mumbai, nearby some Australia or something, might be anything. So it's completely depends on Microsoft. So now let's say you storing some storage account in this particular particular data center. Now every data center has their own clusters and their hardware. Now you put your piece of data into the storage account in this first cluster. Let's assume as we are talking about second scenario, like you know, whenever the disaster happened, natural hazards like floods or something happened to this particular data center, even if this is gone, Microsoft is gonna replicate your data with another data centers across globally. So globally in the sense, even though if the South India is gone, you have multiple locations your data is stored. So they will do the failover. GRS has a secondary storage account. This is a secondary region, right? Now this is a first region. LRS consists of first region and they have a couple of copies in it. But GRS has a secondary region now. Secondary region is a secondary data center. So let's take an example. So the first, our standard storage account URL is, let's take an example, okay. Now, STG. STG stands for storage dot core dot Windows. So this is how the storage account URL looks like. Teststg is your storage account name, and core.windows.net is the default storage account domain, okay, which Microsoft gives you along with your storage account name. If you want to change that, you can actually configure the custom domains to this, and we can do that. So now I don't get confused with the name right now. So just take this is the name. Now if what about, let's say, the secondary region? So now let's take STG. I'm just going to show you how the secondary region URL looks like. Secondary dot core dot windows.net. So this is a secondary, this is the first one, and this is the second one. This doesn't change. Whenever you know, let's say in your application, you are storing some data in this some application data. Your application wants to access this data, it uses this first URL. And you, in this code itself, you will write, a developer will write as, okay, in case if this storage account is not accessible, try to use this second URL. Okay, that won't be accessible now. You can't actually access the data. Whenever this is not accessible, whenever the first URL is not working, then go with the second one, because Microsoft is going to do the failover. Okay, first they will try to fix that issue whenever they have some issues with the hardware or some data center issue. So they will actually try to fix it on demand, and if it is not going to work out, then at final step is to do the failover. Just they will do the network failover. What happens here is your primary becomes, you know, the storage account is not accessible. Now in that kind of scenario, you know, you have to use this secondary URL. So if you try to access the secondary URL, you will be able to access the data. That's how, you know, it happens in GRS. So it doesn't matter you don't know you from which database you sorry which data center you are actually accessing the data by using the second URL. This second URL maybe you are accessing your data maybe from the Australia or maybe from the West India. So it depends. Microsoft, however they do the failover, it depends upon them, but the URL is this one. So just after the dot you will have the name called secondary. Okay, this is the one we can actually see this in the overview also, Azure portal overview, but this doesn't work out, guys. We'll see the next step. So you understood about the GRS concept. We'll quickly move on to the RAGRS. RAGRS is also a similar kind of concept. So I think instead of drawing, I can see it here, show it here, because everything is same. Read access geo-redundant. Read access in the sense you are getting extra read access to the same GRS. GRS is same. The replication, everything is same, but RAGRS, you are actually getting a read access to the secondary location. Now, let's say only once this is failed, then Microsoft is going to give you this particular URL. With this, you are able to access the storage. But in this RAGRS, Microsoft is giving you the secondary storage a link as well as you can access the data, which means even though this is up or running or it is failed, Microsoft is giving you the secondary link in the overview blade of the storage account, where you can just click on that. Whatever the data you see in this, that will be replicated with the second one. Okay, we'll create a sample storage and we'll see how it is gonna look like and how to access that data using this RAGRS. And out of these three replications, RAGRS is very, very, very costly. So people will mostly go with GRS or LRS, a kind of scenario. It depends. If you have some critical data, then you go with this RAGRS, read access geo redundant storage. So that's a quick intro about this replication type.
Shiva, a small doubt. Shiva, what exactly this RAGRS does? You told that it's very similar to standard GRS. So when standard GRS is able to provide us the secondary link and we are able to access the data globally and locally as well. So then what is the use for going for read-only GRS? I mean, what is the read-only?
Right. As I told you, when in GRS, actually you have the secondary link, but you can't able to access it. When you can actually access it, once the first main primary storage account is down, in that kind of scenario, Microsoft, they will do the failover and they will provide you the secondary link in the overview blade. Let's take example. South India is temporarily down and you don't know the secondary URL also. In GRS, they are not going to provide you, but earlier we used to see it in the overview blade. Now they have completely removed it. Let's say the South India is down. When you go to the Azure portal and when you refresh the page, instead of seeing this URL in the storage account, you will be able to see this URL, a secondary URL which pops up in your overview blade. So when you just click on that, then you can able to access your data, not from this primary South India. You are actually accessing the data from West India or Australia. Okay. The difference between this RAGRS is, when I say RAGRS, the first link and second link will be both available on the storage account overview blade. You can actually access from the secondary storage also. Whatever the data you connect to the, let's say you are using the primary URL and you are connecting to South India, and you can actually access the secondary URL also, read access geo redundant, which means you have the read access to the secondary locations also. So now if you select that and if you just try to browse the same URL, see, let's say I've created a container called test and I have uploaded some file. Now if I use the secondary URL and just if I instead of just you know, the file and the extension or URL will be same, but the secondary location also will have the same data, which is replicated in fraction of seconds. We'll see that in lab so that you will get a clear picture. So I'm going to put some data and I'm going to show you the lab now. So we'll quickly move on to the lab part, because theory, you know, how much I say, you know, you'll be into a confusion state. Now we'll see practically so that you will get some clear understanding about these replications. So moving back to Angel portal, we'll quickly see the types now. So I'm going back. So I have shown you how to create a storage. So just go to the market store, select types of storage account, then select that. So you will be into this particular blade. We call it as a blade, guys. So whatever the screen that you are seeing here, a window, small window for the storage, that is called as a blade. So when I say create, it will give you a couple of questions like what is the name of the storage, everything. So as I said, this is the domain, custom domain, which is, I mean, Microsoft is giving you this domain. Now the storage account, I'm going to say MOSTG. It is not available. So it should be globally unique and it doesn't take capital letters and it doesn't accept special characters. It should be very should and no spaces again, and only small letters are accepted for the storage account. It's a naming convention, guys, do remember. And whenever, why I'm telling you here is because in portal it is giving you that green tick mark, but in PowerShell it doesn't know. Okay, you after executing the commands you may fail because you can't give you any special characters at the, I mean, and capital letters. So just be careful, only give only numbers and small letters only. So it only accepts those. Now, deployment resource manager, everyone knows, as I said, account kind, version 2, version 1, and people who only wants to blob storage can actually go with the blob storage. So currently version 2 is a little bit costly, like for using the virtual network. Anyhow, we have not covered the virtual network topic, so we'll see this later. So now I'm going with a version 1. So now I'm going to take South India region, and we have these replications, right? LRS, GRS, RAGRS. Now, simply I'll go with LRS. I think, yeah. Okay, we'll create a 3 storage accounts with different dimensions. So you have these two types, like performance standard or a premium. Standard type. Now, storage account types. If you go to with the standard, you will get, you know, yeah, you'll get cost when compared with the premium, you get a little bit very less cost, and you know, that would be great. Premium is only used in production scenarios. Whenever you are generating some business out of an application or some storage, you know, you use this premium. So that, you know, let's take an example of IRCTC. IRCTC, we have Tatkal at 10:30 or something, I'm not sure. So that time, you have a huge load on that particular application. So let's say that application has some data that is actually accessing from this particular storage account. In that kind of scenario, if you use the standard storage, what happens in that huge load time? I mean, at 10:30, people, thousands of people connect to that storage account, and if they try to access the data, they may get some latency issues, like performance issues on the like application side. So in that time, it's better to go with a premium storage. That is actually a production scenario. That's the reason I gave you example. No, as of now, we are just testing it, so I'm going with a standard. Now standard. And here we have one more option called encryption. So this is a transfer required. So which means, like a secure transfer, whenever you are transferring the data within a storage account or from one storage account to another storage account, if you enable this, encryption will be enabled to your data. Whatever the data you are actually encrypting, that will be encrypted. So it doesn't copy, like, you know, what you copy from your local machine to pen drive. So whatever the data you are copying, every piece of data will be encrypted into some other format. And then the data will be copied into the destination storage or destination place. So by this mean, what you are going to achieve. So whenever people, you know, whenever they try to hack, or, you know, so the in that point of time, you know, even though they got some data from your transfers, so they don't, the data doesn't work because that is completely encrypted. They can't understand the format because that is a machine understandable language. So that's you know, encryption. You know, whenever you enable it is costly because Microsoft is giving you this additional feature. So whatever you see in this Azure, you know, it's costly only. I mean, not costly, like it is chargeable. So it depends upon your usage again. If you use very less, you'll be charged less because it's a cloud offering. So that's how it should be. Now, subscription is pay as you go. And I'm going to say my create resource group test demo. I'll say demo. Here you can give anything. So I'm going to say a demo. Now you have this virtual network concepts here. So now I'm not going to use virtual networks as of now. Data leaks, people, as it's in previous.
Yeah, Shiva, we version 1 storage, we don't have virtual network. And for V2, that is the advanced feature which we are having virtual networks.
Yes, so the compatibility will be, when you compare with, let's say in version 1, you can take the virtual networks, but compatibility is very, very less. You know, it doesn't support properly, and you have latency issues or performance issues when you go with this. So it's recommended to take a version 2 which has new features in it, like virtual network appearing and all. But it's not suggested to go with version 1. I mean, Microsoft recommends you to use the latest version, because there are some people who are using the old storage account from long time. For those, the feature is as it is. So after a couple of days, how they have removed this classic portal, they are going to remove this as well. So it's mandatory. I mean, after that, you have this option, right? Virtual network. Either you can use it in V1 also, or if you want, if you don't want, you can ignore it. Similarly, how we have this classic. Now they have removed the classic portal, but still you have the classic options in the ARM portal. So similarly, they have given this particular feature in the V1 blade, version 1 blade. So it's as if default, it's your option whether to go with this or not. But that is the added feature in the version 2, okay? So earlier you don't have this. I think in our previous classes, we don't have this.
Yeah, okay.
Right.
And do we have any full form for blob, I mean, like definition kind of thing, or is it just blob?
It's a blob where you can store any kind of data. Whatever the data you store inside the blobs, okay, we call it as blob data. Okay. And the specific definition for that is, it's similarly like a storage where you can actually store some data. I think a particular definition, I think I'll share you the documentation. I think I have the storage account documentation. In that, you'll have all the details. Okay. After this class, just remind me, Abhi. I will give you access to a. I have created a folder, so I will upload some documents to that. You can go through the topic by topic.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Now I've created a storage with the name called demo STG. So I'm going to create one more storage account with a different application called RAGRS and GRS. Let's do that. Create. So demo 121. Okay. Now it's fine. South India is fine. Now I'll go with GRS this time. Take existing resource group, because everything will be in a single shelter. So now I say create. Yeah, now I'm going to create one more. RAGRS. By default, it is giving you RAGRS. It's recommended. Microsoft is going to get the money from it. Okay, I'm going to select existing demo resource group. Say create. It's very simple and it's very easy to create the storage. We'll see with PowerShell as well, how to deploy the same resource using PowerShell. So we are seeing this with portal, right? I mean, yesterday we have covered how to create a Azure resource using PowerShell. It's very simple as that. Yesterday we have used a command called new hyphen Azure RM resource group. But here we are creating a storage account today. So just instead of resource group, just replace that with a storage account. Then you're able to create a storage account. We'll see that.
Shiva.
Yep.
Karthik here. So where exactly we can see that the limitation of the storage, 500 TB, which you were telling.
Capacity.
Yeah.
I mean, it's nowhere mentioned in the storage account details. I mean, in the Azure portal, it's nowhere mentioned there, but we have a separate page called storage limitations.
Okay.
Storage, Azure storage limitations. It's a Microsoft article. They have given it here. Storage limitations. No, not here. Yeah, here you have it. Every resource has certain limitations. So we'll see those. Let me scroll down the storage part. So you have all the services available in Azure. Thanks with yes, right? Storage. See, you have all the limitations here. Now, number of storage accounts per region or per subscription, only 200. Okay. only 200 storage accounts you can create per region, which means in South India you can only create 200, or with entire your subscription only have a 200 storage accounts. You can't go beyond that. Let's say if you want to go beyond the 200 storage accounts, then you have to contact the support team and then you have to tell the valid reason. So you have to give some justification why you want more than 200. Then accordingly they will think and they will approve at least, like, you know, 50 or one more 60 or 70. So it depends. So they don't even, I think they don't even go beyond 250. I think, I mean, when I worked with the support team earlier, Microsoft, so they, you know, those guys, we have a statement like, don't go beyond 50, because even we are not the guys. Anyhow, we will take the justification from the customer and then we'll just move it forward to the other department, like clustering team, where they will, you know, take this request and they will increase the count for your particular subscription. So this is a 200. Now, maximum storage account capacity, this is what I discussed about. I've told you, I mean, this is a 500 terabytes. 500 terabytes is the capacity of your storage account, and the maximum number of blobs, container, files, tables, no limit. And no limit in the sense, only till 500 terabytes. Only till 500 terabytes you can store this. And maximum request per storage account, 20,000 requests per second. So whatever the request in the sense, like what, whenever you give some input or whatever the output you get it from the storage account, the request count is like 20,000. And there are a lot of, you know, options. I mean, limitations.
It's something. Request in the sense, it's something like people who can access at a time to the data. That's the one.
It's not kind of that. You do these API calls, REST API calls. Let's say in storage account you have an image. If you, whenever you click on that image, you know, it shows you some properties, right? Which means you are giving an input to the storage via REST API calls. So I think the developers who are working, so they can understand this REST API calls. What are these APIs? Application programming, something. This
programming interface.
Yeah, application program interface. This developer terminology. So these APIs, what happens here? Let's say you click on that particular image, it should show you the properties. So from where it is showing you. So whatever the click you have done, that is a request. Now REST API, you made a REST API call. The API will go to the data center or Azure application. And then when the customer clicks on this button, what should I show to him? Then it gets some output and then it shows you here. So in the web portal, you know, that's called as, you know, the request. Whatever the request that you made, whatever the inputs that you give to the particular application is called as a request, or the output that you get is also a request again. So 20,000 requests per second, and there are a lot of features. So go through this page. I'm going to ping you this, so you will get some understanding about this. Okay, we have all the three storage accounts available. So where are these three storage accounts? Under a demo resource group. Three storage accounts, demo 1-to-1. So the first one, I think this is GRS. So you have the replication type as GRS, and you see, guys, in the overview blade. Yeah. Now, whatever the data, if I want to store, I just go to the blobs, and I need to create a container. Okay. Test. Okay. So okay. I've created a container, which is nothing but a folder. Okay. I think I should create a private. Yeah. So I missed one point here. So when I create a container, it is giving you the access type. Okay, what type of permissions you want to give to this container. So when I say private, no anonymous access, which means only I can actually access it. Only I can, which means within the Azure portal only this container is accessible. No outside guy, even though you have the URL, he can't able to access it. Microsoft will not give you permissions. Now let's take one more container called test1 or test2. With a different, like blob or container. Blob, we have anonymous read access for blobs only. Now anonymous read access for entire container and blobs. If you have the justification here, so I'm going to say blobs here as of this time. So I have two, test1 and test2. I'm going to upload the same image file into this container. So I have this upload button now available. So when I say upload, you can select one image file. Let's take some image documents, downloads, pictures. No picture exactly. This is something weird. Okay, I'll try to get some pictures from the internet. Okay. One thing me. Private message. Okay, fine. I'll just look at it later. Now I'm going to upload a file. So this is a file just I'm going to upload. So this is a private container, guys. Only I can see. Now I'm going to upload the same file into the second container. So upload. Done. Now I have two files here into this container. So let's go to the first one, private. Now I'm selecting that particular file, and when I go to the properties, okay, I have this URL. Let me tell you this, what is the URL and how this looks like. So as this is private container, so you can't see the data inside this particular storage account. Demo 121 is your storage account name. You are inside the blob. You store the data in the blob, and core.windows.net is the default name which is given by Microsoft. Test is your container name, and this is your file name. Let's say if you have different file, you'll get a different name here. If it's a PDF file or it's a video file, you'll get a video file name. So that's the URL looks like. Now we'll try to access the same file. Okay, you don't have secondary kind of stuff here. Let's say as we are using the GRS replication here, whenever this primary storage account is down, then only you can actually you can't see the data. You'll see error messages like this only. Whenever the primary storage account is down, or you'll say 404 error, or you know, you'll get some kind of different errors. So Microsoft will give you a different URL like 121 dot. Secondary. So this is the URL. This is how the secondary URL looks like. Now, if you try to browse, you can't access the data because Microsoft is not allowing you to access the secondary region. When they are allowing you, whenever the primary storage account is down, then only they are allowing you to access the secondary storage, even though this is a GRS replication. Let me.
Shiva, the Karthik here. So the URL will be automatically updated?
Yeah, it is automatically updated. Yeah, automatically okay. Updated. In GRS, okay. that is where you don't have access. Okay. So okay. Even though you are paying for the service, but you don't get access to the secondary location until unless the first one is down. So I'm taking the URL of the another container which is having different permissions. Now when I say enter, see, you are able to access it. The first one is having primary. So The first one is, you know, first one is like private type. Access policy is private, so you are not able to view the file. The second one is not private, so that's the reason you are able to access the file within this different container. The container is test 2, and here it is test. So it's a difference here.
So private type in the, yeah, Shiva, private type in the sense where we can access this file.
You need to only come to the Azure portal, and there only you can able to access it, not from the outside by using the URL.
Okay. So can you show me from Azure portal, how do we access this private one?
Private one in the sense like you can't able to open the image file. You can only see the data inside this private container. That's it. You can't able to view the files, or you can't able to access these files. Let's call it as a private. Private in the sense like, let's say you have some confidential information, like some project related documents or something. You create a container with a private access policy and you store it confidentially. That's how the private works. And when I say blob or container, you've been able to access it like this. And these URLs, let's say developers wants to put some images in their websites, you know, they will store these images in their storage account and they will pass this URL to the application. So whenever you browse or whenever you go to some visual path kind of sites, you know, the images will be scrolling on the screen, right? Those images are nothing but which are stored in their database or their storage accounts. I mean, not Azure, if whoever people are using Azure. So this is how they use this in real time. So
Shiva, so you mean that private window where we store the data is something like a OneDrive, we can say, which is not visible to anybody, and which where we can just store
right,
the data.
I can say the same, right. You know, whenever you store the data, you have some credentials. After that, once you log in, you can actually access the storage, and inside that, you have the private container. It's like, you know, saving your confidential information, as simple as that. So you can't able to access the data, even though for every file that you store in the Azure, you know, a URL gets generated. Even though you have the URL, you can't able to access the file. So that's how the private container works. Private in the sense, it's simply private, it's not publicly accessible. That's what the definition is.
Okay, so in case if you want to allow the any of the file which is located in private, so you need to move that file to public. That's what you are trying to say?
Right. If you want to make if you want to make this available, you just move it to the different container or just copy that to the different container. So here we have how we can do some modifications or copying the files. So in Azure storage, Azure portal, you don't have a lot of features like copying the data from one storage to another storage, or you know, copying that from one container to another container. We have a different software for that. Microsoft has designed a software called Azure Storage Explorer. So write it down somewhere. Azure Storage Explorer is a tool, so where you can actually copy your data from one storage to another storage. So you see here, it's now it's in preview. They are actually wants to integrate that Storage Explorer software features in this particular portal only. That's the reason they are actually started implementing the standard Storage Explorer, but it's in preview. Preview in the sense like it's still in the development phase. Microsoft is still developing it. If you want to test it, but you can. And they are not sure that whether this is going to work. I mean, they are not pretty sure whether this is going to help you. So, I mean, it's still in production. Until unless this preview name is gone, you can actually think like, okay, this is working now. So don't worry. Now I'm just showing you how to, you know, see, these are all the options that you see in the Storage Explorer as it is. So now I'm going to copy this. See, when I say right click on it, I got a copy button. And when I go to test to container, I have an option of right click. I think we'll have it here. Paste. Simple. Copied blob from demo121 test storage account to another storage account. So where you can see the, let me refresh it. Where is the refresh?
This copy happens in the background within the data center, right?
Yeah, within the data center.
Within the data
center. One container to another container.
Okay, fine. Even the huge file can be done, even in GB files also, it goes between the data centers only.
Right. You can do that any kind of file. So it doesn't matter with the size or something. Simply just copy and paste. So added benefit of using the Windows products. So you'll get a good GUI, user interface. So this is similarly looks like what I show you in the Storage Explorer. In order to download that Storage Explorer, you need to go to Azure SDK site where you have all the downloadable files available. Yesterday I have already given this link for you guys. So I'm giving you once again this link. You have a downloadable files. Just scroll down completely. When you scroll completely down, you have standalone tools. Under that you have Storage Explorer. Select this Windows install. Whenever you click on that, the file will be downloaded, and once you install that, you have this kind of button. See, you have a Storage Explorer installed on my machine. So it's a simple file, like some 40 MB file or something. Once you double click and you just install, click next, and then you go with this tool. So this is the logo, right? When we just open this Storage Explorer, we got it.
So Shiva, why we need to download this tool on our local machine? Is that mandatory? I mean, when we are able to do it in the user interface.
That's what I said. It's a storage explorer. It's still the feature is new feature. So they don't want to Microsoft want to avoid this using using this software instead of using the portal. So that's the reason they have implemented these features. All the features, whatever you have in this particular software, they have implemented it in this feature only. Now it's in still it's in the development stage. It's not ready yet. So let's say now we have done a copy, but it should throw some error here. I think people no one asked me the question like, you know, when I copy the same file, because we have the same file in two different containers, when I'm
same
copying
name.
That from first container to it should ask you like, hey, there is a file with the same name, but it doesn't ask you why, because it's still in development.
But unless
this preview phase is gone,
But Shiva, when we are copying the same file in two different containers, I don't think why it should throw an error. I mean, see, the
because
first container.
We uploaded the same file, right? We already uploaded the same file into two containers. I have pinned that URL and I have showed you the file also.
Correct. See, I have a file in one container which is in private mode, so that means it's not accessible to outside world, and I want that same file to be available to the public, I mean in the different container. So I am moving or copying that file to different container, so that makes some sense, right? So then why it should throw an error? I mean,
I'm not talking about the accessibility here. What I'm saying here is, let me
duplication of data.
Duplication. You are doing the duplication, right? I'm just simply copying that same file from first container to second container, even though there is a same name, same file exists already. So I'm copying the same file again, and it should throw me some error, right? Say, hey, we already have the same file with the same name. So at least you have to rename it. What I'm actually telling you.
Or at least it can create a reference of that, at least.
No. Those features are not there as of now.
Okay.
So you see here, this is the tool. Once you get the tool, you need to log into your Azure account. Whenever you click on this accounts button here, account management button. So you have add account feature. And I say add accounts. So you have this add account feature. And I click on sign in. You know, it will ask you like username and password. So once you provide those, you will get this kind of window. So where it shows you your subscription. Once you select your subscription, you know, when you say apply, automatically you can see all your data, whatever you have. See, this is my subscription, and under this subscription I have three storage accounts. It doesn't matter with the region or everything. So whatever the storage accounts you have under your subscription, it shows all the list. Now I'm going back to the first one. So here I have stored a test container, test 1, test and test 2. So test 1 has a file. So you see all these options as it is. Okay, you have a file, right? So test 2 has also have some file. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to try to copy this file, and we'll try to paste it here in another container. Say paste. See, you got error. See here. Copying block from demo 1 to 1 to demo 1 to 0, completed, comma, one conflict. Expand more for details. So I think I can click on this button. A block with a given name already exists. This is what the error that I'm expecting in the Azure portal. Why I have not got the error, and it gave me some green mark. Green, which means copied the blob. How come it can copy with the same file with the same name, right? So that's what we call it as preview. Preview in the sense the feature is not yet ready to use. It's still in development. But even though if it is in development phase, Microsoft is giving you a chance to explore that feature. Once it is live and all, then you can test it in real time. That's fine. Just for your understanding and for your experience, they are giving you to do some R&D on this feature. Okay. So you can expect bugs, and even you can expect some blunders also, but that's fine. It's in preview. Let's say you got this is ready and it is in production, and then you got this error message, then you can complain this to the Microsoft by going to the help and support. Or when you scroll completely down, you have this new support request option, right? You can just raise a new request, and then they will take it as a bug fix, and they will, you know, they will try to fix that issue. That's how you can
Shiva,
get the feedback as well.
So Shiva, how this offliner is working then? This tool? Yeah, this one.
This one?
The storage, yeah. The storage explorer, this is an offline file. That means you have downloaded the file and we are just again connecting to Azure portal and again we are doing this copy process, right? But again it is going and pointing to the same feature. But when it is working here, I mean, why it's not working in web console? I mean,
that's what I'm saying, Karthik. So this is still in preview, which means like it's not ready. This feature is recently they have implemented this feature, so it's not there like, you know, 3-4 months back this is not there, and now you are learning Azure, right? After 2 to 3 months, just see, just watch and see, you can see a lot of new features in Azure, because the portal that I have seen and that I am seeing right now is completely different. You can't even imagine how Microsoft has done some changes. You know, I have seen all these features in preview mode. Let's compare now. You are seeing a single feature and you are actually wondering here. So I have seen all these features which comes here in preview mode, but I have tested, I have done R&D on this. So this feature is not ready. That's what I'm saying. In the portal, it's still in development phase. But even though if it is in development phase, Microsoft is giving you a chance to do some R&D or to explore that particular feature. Okay. This is similar kind of storage explorer software, but it's not yet ready in web portal. It's working fine in as a software, because you are getting a proper expected error, right? But in portal, you are not getting Azure portal because it's
correct.
Not ready.
Correct.
Yeah, that's what I want to say. Don't get confused. You are getting these many doubts in a small feature. Then we have a lot of concepts like migrations and VPNs. Then I think you have to be very careful, man. That's fine. Asking doubts is fine. I don't block you or I don't say no. But that's good.
Shiva, yep. Then how can we copy any file without any conflict? Like rename.
Without any conflict.
Yeah. The same file that we want to use, then how can we copy? Because while the time of copying, we cannot rename it.
Mm-hmm. Right. Got it. So if you want to copy this file, same, let's take, we have the same file in two different containers and you want to copy this to the second container, right? So I will say copy. Okay, I'll create a container. Container is for free of cost. I'll say right click on a create container. I'll just make it as, you know, test. I already have the test, right? 1, 2, 3. So I'll paste it here. So it is copied and I can directly say rename. Blah blah. I'll say just some pseudonym. And now I'm going to say copy. And just wherever you want, you can just simply copy it and paste. So what we are actually going to do is, this is a little bit lengthy process, right? Simply, I mean, even in Azure or even in your mobile phone also, if you want to do the same, you can actually rename the file, or if you want to rename it, let's say you can actually rename it directly in the container. Even though you rename it, I think you'll be getting confused with this example. Let me put it in different way. Now you want to copy the same file to the different container, because the other container is also having the same file. That's the reason what I want to do is, I want to directly rename this file in the source container. So now I'm going to rename this. Let's say I rename this and I will just simply copy it and I'll paste it in the destination wherever you want. So in your mobile phone also, you do the same, right? Or in your, let's say Windows folder also. Let's say I have two folders in my computer. I have two folders here. New folder one and new folder two. So I have two folders right now. Now I create a text file here. So this is a new text document.txt. And in the second folder also, I create the same. So text document. So same files I have in the two different folders. Now from first folder onwards, I'm trying to copy the same file and I'm going to paste it in the new folder. See, it is giving you the error. As this Windows is, you know, it has some lot of features and GUI. So it is asking, hey, you already have this file. Whether do you want to replace this file in the destination or you want to skip this? Okay. So compare information for both. So you don't have an option of renaming it, right? So what you can do either you have to go to the first container, sorry, first folder, and you have to rename this file, as we are having that same file in the second folder also. So I need to rename this. Okay, now I need to copy this and I need to paste it in the second container. Similarly, like Windows computer, how you just copy normal folders. Now it got copied, the same file, whatever the content you have it in the same, but the naming convention is different, because if you use the same naming convention, it doesn't allow you to copy. Similarly, that's what I have done it here in the storage part also. So now you are done with this container, right? So I'm going to say delete. So delete. It doesn't cost you much. If it is a very huge file, then there is a chance. I mean, even though you just only make it only for a fraction of a second, so it doesn't cost you a little much about it. So clear, guys, clear about this copy process. I mean, it's very as simple as that. Just assume your Windows computer and just do the copy process. That's it. It's not a rocket
science.
It's not beyond that. Yeah, Abhi.
Can we copy it from one storage account to another storage account, like a demo 1212 to demo 1211?
Yes, we can. So
okay, they both are in the different regions also, we can do that, right?
Right. That's the benefit that the Storage Explorer gives you. And now I have a file with this name, sdafsd.jpg. Now I'm going to say copy, and I'm in demo 1-1. This is the RAGRS storage account that we have created. Now in blobs, as of now, I have not created any container, so it's blank. Let me create a new container in the blobs. I'll say this is a test. Okay. In this, I have pasted the file. See, the copy process is done. It doesn't take much, and it copies like fraction of seconds. So now I have copied a storage account, I mean file, from one storage to another storage, one container to another container, and I want to show you this RAGRS, as I have given some explanation about this in today's class. Let me go back to Azure portal and let's access the secondary location for this storage. So I can go to storage. So demo 1-1 is our RAGRS type. You observed GRS doesn't give you the URL, secondary URL. So now you have this secondary RAGRS location, right? Now, when I say blobs, and inside container, we have created a test container, and inside that we have some data. We copied some data. This is the file we have copied. Now, when I say browse, see, you got a URL, okay? Now, I'll paste this, because as this is a private type container, when we have created with Azure Storage Explorer, when you create a container, that becomes always a private container. Okay. So now if you want to change the type, you can actually come here and you have an option of access policy and change from private to different method. So now I'm going to say save. It's saved. It doesn't take much. It's very fast. Now let's refresh the same URL. As we have changed the policy, this is accessible. Now I'll just put some name here. So secondary URL. My mistake. I've given a wrong name. Let me go back. Second demo 1-1 dot secondary dot globe dot co dot windows dot net. Sec. We'll get the overview. Storage type RAGRS. Fine. One sec. We have this URL here. Container. The properties. So this is the URL. Where is the secondary URL? Test one. Fine. Okay. I'm clear with this. I have done a small R&D on this storage part. in my company, what my company expected is, you know, as this GRS is a costly feature, SGRS and RAGRS, they want to copy their storage account. They have almost like 20 to 30 storage accounts, and you know, they want to copy that storage, all the storage accounts, to a single storage, and they want to make it as a backup. You know, there are chances, you know, whenever the primary storage is down, so when the Microsoft makes the secondary storage as primary, so that point of time, in order to avoid those kind of situations, my company wants to have one more storage and copy the data. When I was doing R&D 2 days back also, I could see a secondary URL. Let me check whether they are doing some maintenance work with the storage part. So this is the URL, Azure status. So when you type this Azure status in the browser, you know, this will give you the maintenance regions. So let's say you have all the regions here. So currently I have deployed this in South India. So I'll say Asia, and here, where is South India? Yeah, here the South India. So here in this, let me check whether storage account is having some issues, or that's fine. Let's check in 24 hours whether we have any issues with the storage, because I don't see this replication options, or whether they are doing some maintenance work, I'm not sure. Secondary URL. Let me, I think it's already 8:20. I will do some R&D on this and I'll get back to you in tomorrow's session. I will show you how to access this when you are using RAGRS. I'll show you how to access this data using the secondary location. I'm not sure whether I'm giving you the wrong URL or something. I mean, 2 days back I was doing R&D. I have this in the properties options. Maybe they are changing it and I'm not sure. Let's check. This is the one, secondary. This name is also correct. secondary.blob.co.windows.net. That's how it should be. Or we'll do one thing. Let me create a storage account with V2. Just version 2. Say test. Okay, that's fine. Any name is fine. We'll take the same resource group. But I'll take the replication as RAGRS. Okay. Now say create. Maybe slowly, one by one, the features for the V1 they are going to remove, because anyhow V2 is in production right now. People should use the V2 because Microsoft came up with the new features for version 2. Let's see whether we are getting the secondary URL for our V2 storage account type. Currently, all these are V1 storage accounts. But there should not be a difference like that.
Yeah, Shivam, we need to request a failover when anything goes wrong with the primary site.
We don't need to request anything, because Microsoft.
Then why we need to take backup of existing storage? It automatically, it replicates to the secondary data, and it should be the primary at that time when it has characters.
Even I just informed the management the same thing, because Microsoft is giving you the replication type and you are paying for that, and again, why you want to go with the storage? There are some people who sits in the leadership team, they are like 60 years experience, they don't listen to us. They say like, okay, we don't have trust on Microsoft, then why you are using the Azure product? So they say like, you know, okay, we want to use one more storage account and we want to copy. Why you are doing it for twice? Okay, why you are writing the script and why you are using some apps to do all this stuff? There are some chances, as we are having some critical data in our storage accounts, we don't want to leave it to the Microsoft. Let's say if a primary storage account is down, Microsoft is saying like it takes some time to do the failover. It's not their first priority to do the failover. Okay, they will try to fix that issue. In case the issue is not fixed, they will do the failover. This is what Microsoft says. In that point of time, let's say it takes some like half an hour to 40 minutes to fix that particular storage access issue. So in that scenario, those 40 minutes, your data is not accessible. So that's the reason they want to replicate the data with another backup storage account data. So what happens then? Let's say, even though instead of depending on Microsoft, these guys, whenever the storage account is not accessible within fraction of seconds, they can actually try to access, they can point that application to the backup storage account. That's how they want to manage, even though they are ready to pay extra billing for storage and backup storage. So that's fine with the management. If they are okay to pay, then we need to follow the orders, right? Just creating a script and giving to them. So the deployment got succeeded here. Let's check now. V2, here it is. This is V2. Okay, going back to blobs. So creating a container. Let's take something like this, some different. Create it. Go to the properties. No, this is also as similar as that. 2 days back, I worked on this and I could see a secondary URL and primary URL. There is nothing here. Okay, guys, I think it's 8:30. So I will get a solution for this in tomorrow's class. We'll see how to access the data by using secondary URL, and also we'll see the lab part of PowerShell scripting. So how to create the same storage account using this PowerShell and how to put some data using the PowerShell. We'll see that in tomorrow's class. And sorry for the delay, guys. It's already 8:30. So we'll connect back tomorrow at sharp 7 o'clock. Okay. And let's try to create some storage accounts and let's try to get some hands-on experience, you know, creating with the Storage Explorer tool and some data, uploading some data into the storage accounts. We'll discuss in detailed topics tomorrow. Okay. Thanks, guys. Thanks for joining. If you have any doubts, just raise them when we start the class, like today, so we can just discuss about those questions and answers. So I'll get a solution for these guys. I'll try to speak with Microsoft support team. As I'm using a premium storage, I have help and support. So I can raise it with the technical team. I have the request. So I'll just try to speak with them. I'll get the solution for this.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Thank you, Shiva.
Yep. Thank you. Bye-bye.